up the gang and they come and get janked. Grab me a river, get through with the shit.
How much it would be to NAJZ swap your 240SX or like any similar chassis. So we'll start off, let me get the list out. So first thing is you're gonna have to wanna find a JZ or like SC300, GS300. You can try and use a IS300 JZ, but they have VVTi, so I think there's an immobilizer in it, so you'd have to get it tuned, so. We're just gonna avoid that. NA 2JZ GE from a 1993 Lexus SC300. So, started off, we bought the Lexus for $200. So, that took care of the engine, the wiring harness, and the ECU. Obviously, we weren't gonna keep it in automatic, so we had to buy the clutch, flywheel, and pressure plate. That was around $160. Clutch slave was $19. A W58 transmission was $250 for me, but you can find them cheaper or more expensive with the JZ bell housing. The bell housing for $300. That got the W58 mounted up to the JZ. Next up, you want to refresh it a little bit. Another thing is to get it into an S chassis, you need to get a front sump pan. That was around $160, and then I sold my rear sump for $162, so pretty much made my money back. If you get a GS300, they come with front sump pans, so you don't have to worry about it. RTV for the oil pan and the shifter, $11. I got two cases of it. Spark plugs I checked, good on oil. Headers, I made custom headers, so that saved me money. That was like $15 to make, so. You have to make like two pipes to delete the cat that go down and connect to each other. And then I connected those into a 3-inch pipe that I then connected to the ISR catback. It's kind of like that, and you need it to be like that. So cut that, rewelded that. That got the full exhaust. And then I traded my blast pipes to the farm because the blast pipes were way too loud. Flywheel bolts were $30, I forgot that. The drive shaft was $380. It's a long story about that. I bought a drive shaft from Suspicious Garage. I don't care if I'm saying their names, they're a crap company. It took them like 3 weeks, no information on it, nothing. Emailed them, they said it'd be shipping out that week, nothing that week. Next week, waited like 3 days, it was like Thursday, nothing. So I called them a bunch of times, no answer. Emailed them, no answer. Texted them, no answer. And then I texted them about an hour and a half later, or I just say, this is ridiculous, I want my money back. 2 seconds later, I got all my money back for the drive shaft, so pretty much that was useless. And then I went to CT Drive Shaft, they hooked it up, took like maybe a week. The shifter relocation, it's a R154 shifter relocation, so you have to modify it a little bit, but it literally lines up perfect. The only thing I have to get is a R154 shifter, but my shifter's working fine, so I'm just gonna leave that until the radiator. It actually came in Brian's car, and then we gave it to this kid, Nate. Nate never used it, so I got it back. So we have an SR radiator in here. The radiator hoses, they're just the stock SC300 hoses, they fit up perfect. You have to cut the top one a little bit, but other than that, it's a-okay. Power steering, you don't even have to do anything. All you have to do is the factory S13 hose bolts up to the JZ power steering pump, so that's perfect. And then I got this oil cooler, power steering cooler. I got it for free, so I just sent that on. clutch line, if you're gonna like be doing this from an auto car, the clutch line is an ISR line with the, it literally bolts right into the sleeve, so you don't even have to modify it or get a special fitting. But that's $40 if you're buying that. For the trans fluid, oil, power steering fluid, it was around $70 for that and the filter. Fuses, switch panel, and relays, that was $40. Wired that up. AC delete, it was $20. Well, for the belt. And then you have to buy flat stock. You weld it all together in like a funky shape and you delete your AC. Engine mounts are like the solid ISR ones. It's like, if you find them used, you can get them for like $30. Well, I got those with my KA. Same thing with the engine mounts. I got those in trade for my KA. Fuel line is like $20. You just have to run them under and up, but over the winter, might get a fuel cell and just run them along the driver's side so it's not close to the exhaust. The intake, if you have extra piping around, you can use that. If not, you can buy like, obviously an SC intake or something, but I use extra piping laying around. And extra filter. What else? The coolant gauge is $20. I think that's about it. The Jay-Z swap, mine came out to around $1,900. It's obviously gonna be more or less depending on what options you go with. Forgot to add the transmission cross member. It was like $75 shipped. I got it used and I sold the AC compressor for $50. So, and I sold the car for $200. Made my money back on that. By selling the car and the AC compressor, I made my money back. So, got a free Jay-Z harness and ECU. The fans, I'm using, I think they're eBay. I got them from a buddy at school. I just traded some old tires for those. It's pretty simple to wire up too. There's, you have to add power to 5 wires and 1 ground on the ECU and it'll start. What you have to do is cut, I think it's 76. And that's your neutral safety switch. And that's about all you have to do to get it running.
Yeah.